Hello, Lakers Nation. It's game day. Lakers versus Warriors tonight. Game three. The Lakers need a bounce back win at home. Crypto.com Arena should be rocking tonight. I'm Trevor Lane for LakersNation.com. Make sure you join us over on Playback tonight. Watch the game directly with us, playback.tv/LakersNation. Then come right back here to the Lakers Nation YouTube channel for the post game show right after the game. Joining me is Mark Gunnels to help break down the game, and we'll look at the betting odds as well. Mark, how you doing?
I'm doing good, man. Obviously, we had a great time the other night out here in LA for the watch party. Yes. The game didn't go as we planned it going, but it was nice to see everybody in person. Shout out to all Laker fans that came out. Definitely was a good time.
Yeah, that was an absolute blast, and we'll definitely have to do that again in the near future. But Mark, this is a big game. You know, statistically, the team that wins game three in series that are tied 1-1 tends to go on to win the series. Now, I think even whoever wins tonight, it still could be a bit of a toss-up. But still, this is an important game, especially for the Lakers coming back home. They stole home court advantage by getting one win at Golden State. Now they've got to preserve that home court advantage by winning tonight here in game three. What are some of the things you're going to be looking for in this matchup?
Yeah, the main thing for me is, I know I kind of talked about it before we got on air, but the home crowd tonight. You know, we saw it for the first time in the LeBron AD era, you know, after COVID, right, where he had a full crowd. So we're going to get that again tonight. But I think even the intensity for this one, obviously, is a little higher because now you're in the second round. You're looking to go to the conference finals. And not to mention, you're playing the Golden State Warriors. You know, there is this L.A. versus the Bay type city rivalry thing, Northern Cal versus Southern Cal. So I do think that when you consider all those factors, you're going to get a really, really raucous crowd tonight, especially the way last game went. They know they got to bring it tonight so they can go up 2-1. And then you really put the pressure on Golden State in game four because they can't go down 3-1. So I do think tonight is a really big game for the Lakers. Not going to say a swing game, but I do think it's probably the closest thing to that at this point.
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. And so Lakers Nation, if any of you are going to the game tonight, understand what Mark is saying. He's saying you better bring it. Crypto.com Arena had better be rocking tonight. So if you're going to the game, be ready to make some noise because this Lakers team, they're going to need to feed off of that energy. We know certain players, D'Angelo Russell specifically, does it for a tremendous job feeding off the energy of the crowd, amplifying the energy of the crowd. So hopefully the home court goes a long way towards helping out the Lakers in this game. Of course, cooling off the Warriors behind the three-point line would certainly help as well. And, you know, actually getting to the free throw line at a much higher rate than the Warriors would also help this Lakers side. But, you know, Mark, whenever we have you come on, we always take a look at the betting lines. Right now, the Lakers are 3.5-point favorite. I've seen it bouncing this morning between about 3.5 and 4 points, sometimes down to 3, depending on where you're looking. But the Lakers are a slight favorite in this one so far. Do you think that's the way it should be coming off of a 27-point loss?
Yeah, I mean, because you expect some regression back to the mean, right? You don't expect the Warriors to, especially Klay Thompson. I mean, obviously, he's one of the greatest shooters of all time, but he had one of those performances. I don't think he's going to shoot that well tonight. He's obviously going to make his fair share of threes, but what, he made 8 last game?
8 for 11 last game.
8 for 11, yeah, I don't think that's going to happen again. So I do think there will be some aggression there. And, you know, back at home, we all know how game threes normally go in these type of series when it's 1-1. You kind of typically lean with the home team, especially if things are relatively even between the two teams, and I think it is roster-wise. So I think it's a fair line right now.
Is there anything you're looking at in terms of the player prop market right now for this game? I'm looking at a lot of the lines, and I feel like a lot of them are pretty tough to make a pick on. Do you have any that you can give some insight into?
Yeah, one that I really like, and you know, you may look at it and be like, why do you like this considering his struggles as of late? But I like the over on Austin Reaves points. I got it right now at 14.5. I know his first two games, he scored 10 and 7. I think he's due for one of those games. And when you're betting these type of things, you kind of want to go on the things are going to even out eventually, right? I don't think he's going to continue to shoot this bad. And then especially coming back home, we know guys tend to play better in front of the home crowd. So I do think he's due for one of those games. He can at least get you 15 points tonight. So I feel pretty good there.
You know, and one of the things I'm looking at with Austin, 3 games in a row of no free throw attempts for Austin Reaves. To me, that screams outlier. This is a guy who does a really nice job getting to the free throw line, averaged 4 free throw attempts per game against Memphis, despite not shooting a free throw in game six. He had six free throws in game five against Memphis. He had eight free throws in game four against Memphis. We know Austin can get to the free throw line, and that can be a big piece as far as him covering that and getting above that 14 and a half points. So I do like that one. A bounce back game for Austin Reaves would certainly be great to see. Any others that you're particularly in on, or are you just looking at this Lakers 3.5 point spread?
Yeah, that's my only player prop for tonight's game. I'm also taking Lakers -3.5 for all the reasons I mentioned earlier. I think back at home, the crowd's going to be rocking tonight. The Lakers were embarrassed in game two. You know, I think a lot of people probably knew in the back of their minds, even though we didn't want to believe it, that the Lakers were probably going to lose game two. I mean, it's tough to win both games in Golden State. They did their job still in game one. I just didn't think it was going to be in that fashion, losing by, 30 points or whatever the final score was. So I think that plays a major factor in the bounce back tonight. The focus should be obviously there. You want to protect home court. I think they will tonight and cover the 3.5.
Yeah, 27-point loss in game two. All I can say is, Mark, thank goodness we were all at a bar when it happened. But yes, that was not pretty. Hopefully the Lakers do indeed bounce back today in this one. And we do get that regression, some normalization of the numbers, both the Lakers 3-point shooting, the Warriors 3-point shooting, the free throw rate, the rebounding. But the biggest thing, what version of Anthony Davis do we get tonight? That's the biggest key to this game. Do you get the dominant MVP caliber AD, or do we get the kind of quiet game out of AD that we saw in game two? You have to get the dominant Anthony Davis if you're going to win this game. Is that, are you expecting that? You think we're going to get the bounce back out of AD tonight?
Yeah, I mean, normally when he has a stinker like that, he follows it up with a masterclass performance. So I definitely expect him to get, you know, his 25 to 30 points, 15 type rebound game tonight with about four or five blocks. So I do think he will bounce back for sure. You saw him on the sideline when they showed that camera shot when they were down by a lot. He made that face like, okay, he was shaking his head, you know. So I do think he's going to bounce back tonight for sure.
All right. That's going to be critical for the Lakers. But Lakers Nation, give us your thoughts in the comments down below. Do we see a bounce back game from Anthony Davis? Does Austin Reaves bounce back in the scoring department as Mark is predicting? Again, give us your thoughts in the comments section. Don't forget to like this video as well. And of course, subscribe right here to the Lakers Nation YouTube channel. Till next time, everybody. See ya and stay safe.